This sucker's mine. Look, I really need a ride. Look, I really need a ride.
Hey, killer.
What?
Hey, it's cool. Your secret's safe with me.
What secret?
Haven't you been watching the news?
Once again, our top story tonight, Malcolm Corley, owner of Corley Motors, was found dead at a rest stop just outside the town of Melonweed. Apparently, the benevolent patriarch and CEO was viciously beaten about the head and neck, savagely and without mercy. Police have arrested a notorious outlaw biker gang known as the Polecats.
No.
With the exception of their leader, who is still at large. Roadblocks have been set up along Highway 9 in an effort to apprehend this dangerous and violent criminal.
We've been set up.
Roadblocks suck.
I shouldn't have left the gang there.
Hey, I don't want to hear anything about it. You ain't making me an accessory after the fact. Just lay low, man.
That's your truck out front. I need a ride.
I look like a cabbie to you. Get lost. They're not letting anyone through that roadblock anyway.
Not even truckers?
They turned me around, said police business only. Pigs.
Seem to have a lot of time on your hands. Not to mention Nixon scratches. Am I distracting you? I can do that.
Not gonna happen.
I just killed a guy.
I'm just about to.
I don't think that's good for the table.
Hey, Quahog.
Yeah, Emmett?
I'm gonna be knifing up your table for a while, all right?
The customer with the knife is always right.
Let me show you how to do that.
Not gonna happen.
Good talking to you. Friendly folks you get in here.
Em, it's not what you'd call an I'm okay, you're okay person.
Ah, shut your hole, Quahog.
Look, let me tell you what happened.
I told you, I don't want to get involved.
Psst. Over here!
I'm not putting my lips on that.
Ben, no time to talk.
You know, it stank in there, but I can't remember a better sleep.
You gotta help me. Go find my editor in Corville. Tell him I took pictures of the Corley murder.
You got pictures?
Yeah, but some thug took my camera.
So you don't have any pictures?
Well, I tracked the guy to Melonweed, but I'm not going near the place. They'd kill me. Get my editor. He's gotta get me out of this. Take one of these fake IDs to get through the roadblocks. My career is riding on those pictures. Help me, Ben. You're my only hope.
Oh, don't worry. I owe you one. If Miranda's thug is the same one that trashed Moe's place, that could be Miranda's camera I saw there. But then, who's got the film? Here.
What's that?
Fake federal investigator ID. Could be of some use at one of those roadblocks. Ever hear of this place? Uncle Pete's Mink Ranch?
I remember there used to be some sort of weasel plantation or something up the road.
Down Highway 9 on the other side of them damn roadblocks. I used to pick up mink meat there real cheap and sell it to school lunch programs. That was a good scam.
So how about a ride? What if they search the back and find my bike?
It's buried in a pile of concentrated fertilizer powder. Trust me, no one's gonna dig through that crap. Now you're gonna ride in the engine compartment.
The engine compartment?
Hey, I smuggle stuff in there all the time, and most of it's worth more than you. So stuff your carcass in there quick, and we might hit that mink dump by morning.
Hope you're better with a stick shift than you are with a knife.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, great. Smells like he's got a fuel leak. I love engine fires.
Sorry, sir. Only police vehicles beyond this point.
I'm with the feds, Chunk. Check it out.
Huh? What's this about?
Undercover agricultural sting operation.
What's in the back?
Fertilizer.
All right, move along.
Hope you rubes get your man.
Problem with your truck?
Loose hose, nothing big. I already pulled your bike out. It's sitting right over there. Well, nice knowing you. Gotta hit the road, you know.
Uh-oh. He did have a fuel leak, and he took my fuel line to fix it. That trucker's gonna die for what he did. I couldn't break that lock. Lots of bikes. No mementos. I'll have scars enough to remind me of this trip. That's the insignia of the vultures. I can't believe Mo used to be a vulture. But then again, how else could she have gotten that recoil booster? Looks like a mink pelt. This must be the window Maureen stared out of as a young girl, dreaming of her life repairing toasters. No. I'm not into furs. Junk and a hose I can use on my bike. I don't think Mo would mind if I borrow them. Mo? She took my booster fuel. Why is she running from me? She must think the whole world's against her. I think I know how that feels. That does it. He's dead. That sign. That means I'm in cavefish territory. Cavefish. Cavefish.
This cargo is worthless. We have been tricked, my brothers. Back to the cave.
The place looks deserted. Maybe the boss was wrong and she ain't coming here.
She's coming. We just got here first. That means all we have to do is sit here and wait.
It's bolted on. Well, that's all of them. Can't be much holding that up now. The truck has them pinned. I ain't looking to buy. I'm not putting my lips on that. What a mess. Maybe I'll just take a little. I'm not putting my lips on that. I've done my heavy lifting for the day.
Father Tor. I haven't seen you since you retired from the Polecats.
Hey, Ben. How's my gang doing?
That's a long story. You know any way around Boyahoga Gorge?
Around it? It's miles and miles long, Ben. What's the matter? Don't like bridges?
It blew up.
Ooh, sorry I missed that. Well, you could jump it, like Ricky Myron. Cavefish got his ramp in their hideout, you know.
Where is the Cavefish hideout, exactly?
Somewhere on this road. The entrance is totally invisible, unless you got those weird Cavefish specs.
What are you doing out here?
Well, retirement's pretty boring, Ben. So I thought I'd come out to the old mine road and look for trouble.
You're picking fights?
That's what the old mine road's for, son.
Any fighting tips, Torque?
Ah, Ben, who's tougher than you?
Nobody, but those rod wheelers are uglier.
They're none too bright, either. I'm sure you can handle them.
The vultures are quick. And they're nuts.
The ones with those boosters are hard to whip. Just remember, Ben, it's not about muscle, it's about timing.
What's up with those cavefish, man?
Watch out, Ben. They're not out here for sport. They hijack big rigs. It's part of their religion. Don't get in their way. They're blind, cold-hearted killers.
How do the cavefish ride if they're blind?
Well, they're only blind because they wear those special goggles to shield their sensitive cave-dwelling eyes. Special sensors in the goggles pick up the dots in the road and other large objects and landmarks to help them navigate. Kinda trippy, huh?
Father Tort, I need your help. The gang's in jail and the law...
Ben, I'm not the leader of the Polecats anymore. You are. Can't you see I'm on permanent vacation? Can't talk anymore, Ben. Eating too many bugs.
Well, take it easy, Father.
Give him hell, Polecat.
Look at him run.
It's Nestor's fault.
Get in quick. I have a plan. We're going to lure the Corley women out of hiding with a bike.
Boss, she already has a bike.
Yes, but this one she worked on with her father. It's an emotional thing. Don't try to understand. Now hurry.
Something tells me the bridge is out. Professor Schmetterling's experimental flying suit. I'm not putting... One of the gorge's many casualties. Ricky Myron's infamous gorge jump. This is the last picture ever taken of Professor Schmetterling. Notice, jumping the Cuyahoga Gorge, although tempting, is highly illegal and dangerous. We recommend the recently constructed Cuyahoga Gorge Bridge for trans-gorge travel. Drive safely. Tightrope walkers, hang gliders, human cannonballs. Many have tried to cross the mighty Cuyahoga Gorge, and many have failed, except for Ricky Myron, the Flying Torch, who jumped the gorge on a stock Corley motorcycle. It was later uncovered that he had modified his Corley with a pre-regulation destroyer-class solid fuel recoil booster and an automotive hover lift. Myron said he would gladly replicate the jump to clear his name, but his special ramp was stolen by a mysterious truck hijacking motorcycle gang. Recoil booster and a hover lift, eh? Thanks for the tip, Rick. You're right, though. I'll need that ramp.
not on foot. What's he got that I ain't got? Except for a recoil booster, a hover lift, and a silly-looking ramp with Dayglow flames painted on it. Say there, is that a re-regulation destroyer class solid fuel recoil booster you have there?
Why, yes it is. Ta-da! Anchor or something?
That should have a couple of good boosts left in it.
This time, you're going to...
Yeah.
touch anything without wheels. No. Now there's one thing I've never needed. That's trashed. I don't touch anything without wheels.